again, and then our topic is empty and drawn sentences. But first, let me introduce you its objectives. Number one, recognize errors in constructing the sentences. So in this category, as students are having struggles constructing these sentences, sometimes we cannot recognize some quality sentences, but we are not aware of it. So this topic will help us to be more aware of the sentence we are reading or the sentence we are writing. And then number two, revise to improve such quality sentences. So sometimes we are learning with reports, copy-paste from the internet. So college students are the best. So may naman, our sentence must be revised and then make it on our own. And then three, apply other ways and techniques to correct errors and improve sentences. So having similar terms in one and two, this topic will help us improve our oral and writing skills in terms of sentences. And then also to correct errors or the errors, including misplaced punctuation marks, words or phrases. And then this lesson discusses distinctive features between Kanban and empty. These are vital points to consider in any writing course. So if you are fluent or you just mastered this topic, you can now be more aware of what you are writing sentence or what we are about constructing sentences using my arm up in our own words.
Walang post. Oo, putang ina. Bilisa muna. Nangalay na ako.
So the first topic is empty sentences. It will be discussed by Cyrus and Renbo. But first, let me introduce the definition of empty sentences. A result of this purpose thinking. As students, we are not really knowing in speaking in English, also in writing. So the result will be his or her is. The thoughts or the idea that we want to give justice is not justified when because of the struggle and our grammar. And it is also contains cause and effect, but is but it didn't give justice or the convincing powers and good.
Wait down, say wait down.